on the island again today. Just felt like it. Usually I don't do the same ride twice in the same week. But this is just too good to be true. And I also heard about some dirt and mystery roads up near Buckhorn. So I'm gonna try to find those today. As long as the weather holds out. It is very cool today. And rained very hard overnight and into the morning. But now things are drying up. But you can still feel that cool breeze. It feels great. So let's see how this goes. All right, this is gonna be a colossal shot coming up here because I get to have two of my favorite things to film in one shot. An elliptigo and the Bollards, which if you don't know what those are, you don't know John Dunn, but you will know in a second. Here we go. Two of my favorite things to film when I'm out riding. The Bollards always remind me of my good buddy John, because he always likes to call those out, and he knows he's one of the few people that know the name for him, which always makes me laugh. So if he's seeing this, I hope he comments below. You're the best, buddy. Okay. All right, so back out on the island again. So for me, getting back to the island means riding over the bridge. I know lots of people hate the bridge. I will say on a windy, windy day, any bridge can get kind of dicey. You can get blown from side to side. I've got pretty deep rims on the track here, and you can feel it on the bridge because you're up at a high elevation. The winds on the river are usually pretty tough. Grand Island. It's one of the narrower bridges around here. The Peace Bridge is way wider now, so it's not a big deal, but Grand Island, what's the key to riding across the bridge? I'll tell you in a second. All right, so what's the key? The key to riding across the bridge is like mountain biking. If you look at the trusses, you will ride at the trusses. I learned from my campus crew, Eric and Alex especially. Eric helped me so much with mountain biking because I was so bad at it and I'm still terrible at it. He is like, dude, look ahead. When you look at stuff, when you look down, you're gonna go at it. I have tried not to do that. So for example, mountain biking, you're on one of those plank ride overs. You look down at your front wheel. I ride off them all the time because I suck. But if you look through, if you're going through the trees and you look through the trees and look ahead, your eyes will take you, your brain will take your body where it needs to go. Same thing on the bridge. When you're on the bridge, two keys. Don't look at the trusses, look ahead. Keep focusing on looking ahead and you will get there. That is a big hawk. Nope. That is a bald eagle in the tree. We're gonna go back and look at that. Sorry about that. We will get back to the tips in a second. There he is, Sam. I am kind of pissed at myself for scaring him away, probably with this loud ass truck. They are very smart birds. Obviously, they have better eyesight than us. But you don't see too many bald eagles around here. But they are all over the place. They are on the river. I've seen them on cataragus fishing. Beautiful birds. Sometimes you might mistake them for a hawk, especially the younger ones, because their heads are not always fully white. But that was definitely a big bald eagle. I hope we got him on tape. So anyway, the first thing is don't look at the trusses. Look through the truss, look straight ahead. Look straight ahead, don't think about the trusses. And your eyes will tell your brain where to go, and it will tell your hands where to go, and you'll get through. if you're looking at the trusses, you're gonna steer towards the trusses. The second thing is, when you're riding on bridges, I always like to go in a very light gear up, maybe the little ring, and then switch to a heavier gear on the way down. But always, always make sure you've got good brakes on the way down. Check them often. For example, on this bike with the carbon rims, I just switched back over to this bike a little while ago, the Trek. So I put back in the original pads that came with it, which are cork. So you gotta know that when you start barreling down the other side of the bridge at 30 miles an hour, that you gotta know your brakes. So there you go. Road. So I think this lady right here, or gentleman, sorry, he's coming out of it. But I was told it's a great path. It goes right along the river through Buckhorn here, which is a natural habitat, I don't know, state park, I guess. Buckhorn State Park. Beautiful wetlands. Yeah, here it is. Buckhorn Island State Park Wildlife Sanctuary. So probably a lot of herons and maybe more bald eagles in there. So I put the film out the other day about my ride out here, and somebody commented from campus. One of the ladies, Trista, said, oh, that's one of my favorite places. You got to check out that little dirt road. I looked pretty closely at the map. Nice when you can put it in satellite mode, because then I could see right where this bridge is coming up here. And this bridge that we saw the other day in the film. So I know it's a little bit past that. It's gonna be right before the first driveway on the left. So I don't know, we'll see if we can find it. Here we go. This one, when we said this is a pretty little path, huh? So yeah, I'm gonna continue on. A cool spot out there I missed. Probably gonna regret it, but you know what? That's the nice thing about riding, is that when you miss something, you can always go back and find something new. So very cool. Still some stretches along the water here. This is all This is all beautiful wetlands. Very cool. See this a lot when we're on the 190 right here next to us, going up to Canada or Niagara Falls, and we'll always wonder what it's like down here. It'd be cool to take a canoe or a paddle boat out here, or a kayak. That's what I meant to say, kayak. All right.